monkeys living in a concrete jungle? They're from Africa, but they found a home in between the Fort Lauderdale Airport and Port Everglades. Now, FAU's anthropology lab is studying the monkeys of Dania Beach.
I came to FAU in August of 2011.
Dr. Kate Detweiler spent her career traveling to Gombe National Park to study African primates. The 9,000-mile trip takes 4 flights and a boat ride. It costs more than $5,000. But she had no idea there's a colony of monkeys living just 25 miles south of Boca Raton.
Missy, who's doing her PhD with me, she said, well, is it possible, Kate, for me to do a project here? And I said, Missy, we don't have monkeys in Florida. And she said, no, they're in Dania Beach.
Today, our cameras received special permission inside this protected habitat.
Hi, Rachel.
Hello. How are you?
Good to see you again. Thanks for having me down here.
I have Missy Williams, who's a PhD student, and Daniel Allen Pjevic, who's a Master's of Science student here today.
And if we're quick, we saw monkeys this morning, so we might be able to go
really?
Back in.
Really? Okay, let's get on in.
Dr. Detweiler, she's been studying the monkeys in Africa for quite some time, but you actually brought it to her attention about the colony here in Dania Beach, right?
Yes. The monkeys here in Dania Beach are pretty much a local legend. So when I found this population, I thought it was a great opportunity and project to bring to the lab.
There's some theories on how they got here. What do you think?
When I first started the project, I did encounter different answers as to why the monkeys are here. But we really believe the monkeys escaped from the Dania chimpanzee farm, which was opened in the late 1940s by the Roosevelt family, and they were importing primates in for biomedical use. The vervet monkeys are generally highly adaptable. They're generalist primates. So they can survive anywhere there, provided there is a sleeping tree and access to water. They're highly omnivorous, so they will almost eat any types of foods available.
Sounds like a college student.
Yeah, exactly.
We're now seeing some similarities in how they move and hide, especially in this habitat. This is a mangrove habitat, and the monkeys here are excellent at hiding from us. So what we're trying now is to set camera traps up into the canopy so we can get them at feeding sites. And Daniel's here to actually set up the camera trap if you want to watch how it happens.
Yeah. Who had the idea that, hey, let's send Daniel up in a tree?
It was Kate's idea originally.
Of course it was. So you'll set the camera trap, and once you leave, then that's when the activity starts.
Oh, sure. Yeah, and they'll come right over to the camera. Particularly the juveniles typically will come right over and even they'll touch it. Sometimes they'll actually break a camera, open the camera, and do some damage.
Someone's interested in studying anthropology. Why would FAU be a good choice?
You have this incredible opportunity to work with a population that is local but yet not native. And then the projects in Africa, in Tanzania, and in the Congo give this incredible opportunity to study them in their natural habitats. So we are starting up a program that hopefully is local yet global.